So, I am back with more Five Nights at Freddy's 2. You are probably watching this about 2 seconds after the last one, but I actually had to use the bathroom, so I'm recording this about 30 seconds after the last one. I know, time paradox. The time paradox that is YouTube. You know what else? On the same topic as I was on last time, about how it takes this guy about 60 times longer for this guy to actually do this stuff. So would that mean like, I mean, look here. This is obviously like max speed for turning his head. That takes about 1.5 seconds. So that means that for this guy, it's taking him like 90 seconds to move his head from left to right, even as fast as he can. Seriously, why would he take 1.5 minutes turning his head from left to right? Like, who does that? This guy's life is at stake, and the fastest he's moving is like 1.5 minutes to turn his head. Seriously, his life's in danger. Actually, maybe that's why the guy called him and told him that it's best just to do the rest of his shift, and then instead, because it's too dangerous to leave in the middle of the night. This guy must move so slow because he's so overweight that it would just kill him. Okay, I didn't even mean to put up now. But seriously, it's taking this guy 1.5 minutes. Wait a second. What the hell? I didn't even put the mask on at all, and I was safe from Bonnie. Hold on. 1 second. Cut everything. What the hell just happened? Okay, what the hell just happened? Can I say that enough times? You can bet your ass we're experimenting more with that. Because, is that a bug? First off, I didn't even move the mouse. As soon as Bonnie popped up, I literally didn't do anything. I just dropped the controls, and all of a sudden the camera spontaneously picks itself up, and the second I take it down, not only is Bonnie gone, despite the fact that I should be dead, but the marionette comes in instead, and I can keep rhyming, but I'd rather be dead. Poetry by random YouTuber, you don't even know the name of it. Is that a glitch? I don't know. Why are you asking me? I don't know. Did Bonnie just decide? Because I'm going to test that out right now. No, don't do that. You can bet your ass that I'm testing that out right now. Come on, Bonnie. I need you to kill me. Really? Right when I need Bonnie to try and kill me. Balloon Boy's like, oh, I'm sorry, I heard you wanted to die. Can I help you with that, mister? Please, sir? Please. My mommy says that if I can kill someone tonight, she'll give me a nickel. Don't ask. Wait, no, I didn't mean to put the mask down. I wanted to die. So yeah, I'm gonna do my best to beat Night 6 by the end of this half hour. But, eh. And wow, now New Foxy's suddenly showing some balls of steel. Hello. I wonder if that works with the other animatronics, too. Alright, perfect. Foxy, right on time. I need you to kill me. Damn it, chicken! Bonnie, are you even listening to me? I need you to murder me and stuff my corpse into a big robot suit. Hello. With your creepy ass eyes. No, Balloon Boy. I don't want to die to you. I want to die... Right? Dang it! I didn't mean to put the mask up. It was a force of habit. Force a Nabbit the Habit Bandit. Flash, flash, flash. Flash, flash, flash. Who you gonna call? Flash Bustas! What? Really, Bonnie? You do realize, this is the perfect... I will let you kill me. This is your perfect chance. It's your time to strike. Time like the present. Hey, Foxy, I got a present for you. Up yours. Really, Bonnie? Really? The one time I want to die to a mechanical psychotic bunny. Cause yeah, new Foxy's definitely becoming more stubborn too, so I tried to keep the mask on longer than I normally do. And just as I was about to take it off, guess who decides to be a real dick in the box? Well, you don't need to guess since you're the one who saw it. Yeah, you. Who else am I talking to? You're the only one there, aren't you? Come on, Bonnie. Do something. Murder me, Bonnie. Murder me, Bonnie, has come with everything you see here. Tell me that is not the name of a demented children's toy. And I will punch you. No, I won't. This isn't Tom and Jerry logic where I can just stick my hand into the... onto the other side of the screen, then punch you. But trust me, I would if I could. Really, Bonito? The only times I want you to murder me. Also, just think about how long it's taking this guy to put on his mask. It takes about half a second for us. So must be taking this guy 30 seconds to put on this stupid mask, a helmet. And that means that the animatronics must be like really patient. God damn it, Bonnie! Damn it, Balloon Boy! Curses, Balloon Boy, you have foiled my plot for world domination once again. Oh, I didn't even stick his head out. I wonder why I accidentally switched the camera. Weird, because I actually have my finger on control. Oh well. So, we continue our quest to get murdered by Bonnie. And each time I mess it up somehow. Oh, and I'm recording this around 8 o'clock right now. Closer to 9, actually. So it'll probably be going up around 10-ish or 11.
Hello.
If they make another Mega Man, okay, I want that to be the ending theme to Mighty Number 9, the ending theme. Inafune, I know you're watching this, Inafune, you totally are. So make it happen, Inafune. Right, guys? Inafune is totally watching this. Because, I mean, my last video went up last night and got no views. But surely Inafune is watching this one. That's what I do when this gets too serious. It! Why is it whenever I want to die to mechanical robot, to mechanical crazy bunnies, I can't? Huh? Tell me, why can't I die to robot bunnies? And that should be like a TV show, Attack of the Killer Robot Bunnies, if not at least a movie. And yeah, this guy must be a real badass because of how deeply he breathes whenever he's just wearing a slightly snuffy costume. Oh no, poor him. God, I can't imagine what happened if this guy moved to Florida. Unless he's already in some southern part of the world. I don't know, maybe he is. I mean, sometimes he acts like a real dumbass and... There once was a fox man who was annoying as shit. Two of them to be precise. And then I killed them a bit. And then I tried to kill myself to a big robot bunny, but then he really thought that my jokes weren't funny. So then I killed myself. The end. And then there was a robot chicken. I don't know what rhymes with chicken. And once again, my flashlight went on before Fox even showed up. Go on, replay the footage, I dare you. You'll see it. You'll see the truth. The truth shall be exposed. One of these days, I'll get you kids. You know, I wonder, do the minigames cycle over? Because I got the same game twice. The first one, of course. Because from what I've seen on other people's videos, they do seem to be in some order. Some specific order. So I've been watching a lot of Pokemon's videos about Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, and I really like the new sword thing with the Mirage spots, and thankfully it's not going to be like Mirage Island. Speaking of which, if Mirage Island comes back, I'm going to be pissed, because I spent years just checking my game every single day in the hopes that I would one day find Mirage Island, but it was never there. I mean, seriously, who puts an island? Who puts an island in the middle of the ocean that people rarely go down once they get fly, and then they make it so that it's rarer than shinies? It's not a good idea. And I swear, Foxy jumps in when Chica goes. No, but he was probably close. And once again, I'm unintentionally rhyming. And I'm yet to find the word that rhymes with rhyming. Shining? Okay, shining. And the new robots, they were really shining. But the old ones look like a piece of crap. Except for Mangle. He sucks anyways. Come on, Foxy. Everyone knows that you're the most annoying. Damn it. I'm not trying to win. I legitimately am trying to lose to this thing. Which is honestly quite funny. Because it really doesn't work that way. Oh, for a second I thought I might actually mess up. Guess not. Oh, and by the way, watch Foxy appear in 3, 2, 1. Knew it. Also, I wouldn't be surprised if the new Foxy snuck in just now. Nope. Okay. Good. One, two, three, four. Okay, I really did take my mask down when I said 4. But, obviously, I should have waited 3 seconds. Okay, so now I know that 3 is a safer number than 4. Because obviously they can't have it so that, it would be total bullshit if new Foxy stayed longer than, old Foxy, would, take. So next time I'll do 3 seconds, that should be enough. But man, night 6 can be really rough. This is probably annoying the whole world out there, but I really don't care. But hey, it's my throat that's killing me now. So I guess I should care. He's Foxy the Flying Rat. I told you, I'm not a rat! I'm a hedgehog. Oh, for God's sake. Bonnie, I know I've been begging you to kill me, but that's not the way I wanted it to happen. Is this the cake one? Oh, I guess it isn't. Okay. Go, 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 go! I can't move. So, why am I hurrying? Okay, this again. Go, 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 go! Oh, crap. Okay. This must be what they meant by Foxy was being ripped apart at the end of each show. By the kids. And then this happened. And jump scare! Ooh. Oh, never mind. So I think that Shadow Man appears to be the guy who's tampering with all the animatronics. Because that was, I believe, I wasn't paying attention, but I think that was 4 kids who just turned up dead. Not to mention the fact that in the one where we brought cake to the kids, there was another one who was dead, making a total of 5. Not to mention there's a creepy Shadow Man hanging around. And apparently one of these jump scares has something to do with Golden Freddy. Could it all tie together? Of course. Wait, no, I'm literally having an epiphany right now. I need to drop that voice. Let's see. Okay. Alright, I think I got it now. It's just a normal day. Freddy's bringing cake to the kids. Foxy is bringing gifts to the children. Chica is feeding them, I guess. Freddy's performing as always. Wait, no. Bonnie's playing. I don't care. My point is, it was a normal day. There's a Shadow Man, and something happens to 5 kids. Golden Freddy is lying around in some of these games. And as you can see, while playing as Freddy at night, it's got something to do with the marionette. So, my guess is the marionette and the murderer have some sort of tie. And yes, I have accepted that this is a prequel. And what's with someone tampering with the animatronics? Hmm. Yeah, I'm gonna wait until the end of the game to start piecing together little bits of information. So I'll wait for the whole analysis. And wow, my throat hurts now. Alright, I'm only gonna record for another 10 minutes or so. So probably just two more attempts. Teddy bear, he does whatever a Freddy does. Oh, come on. I really am trying to die to her. I'm just too good, guys. I rule at this game so much. Then again, I've been stuck on night 6 for the last 2.5 episodes. Alright, Freddong. Hey, I wonder what would happen if I pulled one of those wires. If he really is a ghost, would it hurt if I just started to, like, pull his wires? Would that be, like, his veins or something? Because the badass are playing, I should really try that. Then again, I don't care if you're wearing a Freddy mask. Freddy probably wouldn't be too happy about that. He's gone, no one's there, and I'm gonna wind you up.
Hello.
Okay, it's just Freddy, no big deal. Alright, I flashed them twice. That should be enough to stun them until now. Really? Flashing it twice is enough for New Fox to go away? And come on, Bonnie. You know, Bonnie, if you did, I am legitimately curious. Mommy, why is there bullshit in this world? Because, son, the world's gotta smell like crap sometimes. And no, I have no idea where I'm going with that. Alright, there's Foxy, and there's Bonnie for some reason. Come on, let me go. Oh, great. Double great. Come on, Chicanha. I really have to risk it. Maybe I just let new Foxy sneak in. Maybe Foxy's about to kill me. Nope. Okay, good. It's just old Freddy's here. That's all. No big deal. Thank God. You know, depending on the chance, that could have just turned out way worse than it did. So I'm pretty thankful. You know, I've officially given up on actually trying to lose to Bonnie. As of right now. Come on, who's there? Can't believe I'm even bothering to ask. We all know it's just Foxy. And probably Bonnie too. Because it's me, and you, and Bonnie. And once again, I flashed it before he jumped me, but I really think that's a bug that should be fixed. Okay, thanks. Because flashing is supposed to stun him. So why do I die if I flash them? Go back and watch the video again. I flashed them before he killed me. I flashed them before he even started to jump. And if there's anyone asking why my nose is stuffed up for some reason, yeah, I am coming down with something. But of course, I can't just take a sick day because I'm in school, particularly the 8th grade. So it's sort of an important year to do good, for obvious reasons. If there's one thing I hate about the American school system, in particular the New York one, more than anything else, is that just being out sick a couple of times, even if it's medically excused, can keep you from getting into a good high school. Which is complete bullshit. Recording for an hour is bad, especially when nothing's really going on at a time on a weekend, because then there is absolutely nothing to talk about. So, let's play for me lesson for me number one. Try not to record 2 episodes on Sundays. The only reason I'm recording 2 today is because I promised it last time for God knows what reason. Damn it! Ugh. At first, I was... So here's the deal. At first, I was actually trying to survive, so I tried to put down the mask. But then, when I somehow messed it up 3 times in a row, I decided, oh wait, you know, I'll just see if I could repeat the glitch. And then, wouldn't you know it, I accidentally put down the mask and messed up again on 2 fronts. In fact, it was pretty much 3 fronts, considering the marionette. Alright, last attempt, because I'm really tired. And yes, I do know that in the one of earlier nights, the first night actually, the guy said that there is a... He said that there was a... no doors, because that was sort of the theme with the whole, place, that there shouldn't be any doors, and that was apparently a popular design to them back then, which is why there aren't any doors. But I'm just saying that if there's unlimited power, it would have been awesome to aside from a video game standpoint, to have doors in this game, because you could keep them down as long as you want. And of course they couldn't do that, because that would just make the game unbelievably easy. But really, the best excuse they could come up with is that this have... I'm gonna see if it works with Chica, too. No way. No way. Oh my god. I did not see that. Oh, duh. I'm stupid. They snuck in, of course. Alright, so don't do that, because instead of instantly dying, they'll just sneak in. But I guess you could do it if it's like 5:59 a.m. Because then, as long as you don't take your camera down, you'll be fine. Putting it up is okay, but as soon as you take it down, you're dead. So your only problem there will be Foxy, of course. Also other animatronics, I guess. And I know I said one more try, but that was a 30-second attempt. Okay, so now I know it wasn't a glitch at all. Okay. Because for a second I thought that Scott messed up on the simplest thing. I mean, I guess it's safe to assume that nobody would do that, but you have to account for every possibility when making a video game. Because people do lots of weird shit in games. That's what I've learned by playing for a long time. Well, at least I can say it's not a glitch, so the game doesn't lose points there. Alright, just Freddy. His teeth are surprisingly white for being an old rundown animatronic. He must, even in his destroyed state, he still remembers to brush his teeth. What an incredible guy, ladies and gentlemen. And even when he's like popping up right in your face, it's not like Chico's like, "Rawr, I'm gonna get you." Or Bonnie's like, "Hey, sup, asshole." No, he's just like putting a microphone right up to your mouth, saying, "Hey, buddy, get up here. It's your time to shine." You know, maybe Freddy really is a good guy, particularly the old one. I think Freddy and I are gonna get along just fine. I mean, he's pretty much killed me like once so far. Maybe not at all, I can't quite remember. Well, I messed up. I hate how, like, the position I'm in. It just makes it really difficult for me to move the mouse comfortably. As you can see, the box is open and he's gone. My day. Oh, Foxy, that was a shock. Well, that's it for- Okay, this one again. I wonder if this is like Silver Surfer, you can't touch any walls. Or who knows, maybe you just can't touch any of the animatronics. Oh my god, hyper, well, not so hyper-realistic blood and jump scares. Oh! Whoa. You know jump scares? Well, no jump scares. This is clearly the worst game ever. How dare they put this on the market? No jump scares? What is this? Some 2-year-old's game? Well, this has been a rather pointless episode. You know, I'm probably just gonna put in the title, "You don't need to watch this one," because absolutely nothing was accomplished, so, see ya.